very confusing too, though, from an education perspective. There's all different types of CBD in the market that, you know, which we can talk about too, which from a consumer perspective becomes really complicated in a space that there's no barriers to entry, to your point.
Let's do that. So if I, let's pretend that I decided to start a CBD company today. And so maybe I go on Alibaba, or maybe I just Google like CBD oil and I just see stuff. Man, I don't even know if there's like a quality assessment, probably not. But how did you guys go in your process of getting to either high quality or high functioning, whatever it is, whatever the label is?
I would say first, good luck getting a bank account. That was the okay. first. That was the first thing that we were just blown away how difficult it was just to get a simple business checking account. I mean, you could literally walk into a bank and set one of those up in 5 minutes. Pretty much had to go to the ends of the earth. Now we don't have any banking issues given the size of our business and the capital and the funding and things like that we have. But it was really, really difficult because we wanted to set everything up and do everything the right way. You can obviously not do that, but you run the risk of your assets getting frozen. We've seen these happen to companies in real time, you know, when we're early stage, and we still see it today.
Did you guys have to go to Canada?
No, we're lucky to find something domestically. We don't even share it still just because it was like a competitive advantage, but we found a bank that had a big THC practice with dispensaries and things like that. And we were their first CBD company. THC is actually easier to set some of those basic business things up just because there's just a big structure put in place. And if you want to open a dispensary or store, there's just like a very specific way you go about doing that. CBD is just such a gray, open-ended thing that there really wasn't a process in place. And so a lot of, you know, banks just weren't touching the category and pretty much still aren't. So to go back to your question though, in terms of just like finding product and, you know, where it's sourced and all those things. So when we looked at the space and, you know, started reading and doing a lot of the diligence on it, it was really obvious that not all CBD is the same, meaning from how the plant is grown to what ends up in a bottle that a consumer will consume or take home. And for us, we really wanted, again, because we were going to have this athletic focus and we understood athletes are so interested in trying it because recovery, sleep, like inflammation, like those are huge things for athletes to focus on. And they're constantly looking for the edge and if I can sleep better, if I can recover faster from a workout, that's massive for them. But they're like, I'm not touching this stuff. Like I can't fail a drug test because my career's over. So for us, it was hugely, hugely important to find the right partner and process to take a very high quality product and to make that we could put our stamp of approval and say like, you will not fail a drug test if you use Beam. I would just say like, we have a lot of trade secrets in our process, but we go through a very diligent testing and filtration, all these different things that our standards in terms of like THC and other stuff in it is way below just what the industry standards are in terms of like what can be in the product. So we go even below what allows, you know, technically you're allowed to have trace of THC and all these different things. We test it to a degree stronger to go way below those standards, just because we pretty much ride the whole brand on that in terms of the transparency and cleanliness of the products.
When you say lower, you literally mean like the parts per million or something. You mean,
yeah,
right? You mean you're getting
parts per billion.
Yeah. Parts per billion, PPBs, yeah. Okay, so you don't mean lower, like your standards are lower. You mean the trace amount.
Standards are higher. The parts
standards are higher.
Yeah.
Got it. Yeah, it's interesting to me because, and maybe you can correct me if I'm wrong. In my head, it's just a plant, right? So it's like, how complicated can it be? But apparently it's really complicated for some reason. Why is that? Do people just start adding things to it?
It's all about the process. Like, I'm trying to think of a good analogy. I don't know. This might be a stupid one.
Getting a piece of steak at, you know.
Yeah.
A really great steakhouse and getting a beef patty at McDonald's. Like it's just, okay. Or like even like a hamburger bun you get at McDonald's. I mean, I think you can leave that thing out and it doesn't go bad for like years.
Yeah, that actually is a good analogy. I mean, like it's all beef, right? But like how did it get there? Where did it come from? How was it sourced? How was it processed? Who touched it? How did they touch it? All of those things that just are just mind-numbingly detailed.
Yeah, that makes sense. I want to thank McDonald's as our sponsor at this time.
Hey everyone, thanks for checking out that clip. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit the like button down below. And if you're interested in hearing the full episode, it's out right now on our YouTube channel. We've had a lot of great guests come on this show before, and we've got a lot of great guests coming up in the future. So hit subscribe so that you don't miss a single episode. And one final note, we're always looking for new ideas and new companies to feature on the show. So if you know of someone or know of a company, write us a comment down below letting us know who they are and what they do. We'd be happy to have them on the show. Till then, I'll just be here waiting for your comments. So see you later.